Today's adventure begins on a lonely stretch of road in the middle of nowhere, Arizona.
Howdy folks, I'm Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, and today we're going to be exploring Agua Caliente, Arizona, and the mystery of Sundad. What's left of Agua Caliente, Arizona, I can already see. It's out that way, there's some white buildings, hinting at the main attraction here in Agua Caliente, and we'll get more into what that is in a little bit, but first, there's a pioneer cemetery as you make your way over to Agua Caliente, coming the direction I did from Interstate 8. So we are not too far from Gila Bend, kind of in between Gila Bend and Yuma, Arizona. Anyway, let's enter the Pioneer Cemetery. So Agua Caliente really has its roots in the 1800s in the Old West, primarily. And I can already tell for a Pioneer Cemetery, there's a lot of unmarked graves and a lot of forgotten souls here, which is not uncommon with a lot of these Pioneer Cemeteries we visit. And it should give you a hint. Now this is old. This is really old. And a story of the Old West.
Okay, so here's John George Harry Soldanels from Independence, Missouri. He was born in 1862 and died here in Gila Bend in 1901. That is more indicative of the time frames we're talking about today.
Now, there's really nobody notable that I know about, unless I'm ignorant, buried here. And like I said, a lot of the names are forgotten, but at one point in time, going all the way back, maybe to the 1850s, 1860s, as a lot of the white folks started coming out west, they discovered some hot springs here in this area. Hot springs that the natives probably used for hundreds of years before that, and the Apache also that once lived in this area knew about these springs, and there's some stories or legends associated with that also. But eventually, what you see out there, those white buildings, became a resort for people to enjoy the hot springs in the Old West. Yes.
And as always, you know, there are a lot of the things today I couldn't find too much information on, especially one of the things, Sundad. And I know folks here at one time were very well acquainted with these places and would have all of the answers we seek. But unfortunately, they can't talk anymore. Now, I read some stuff on the internet about this cemetery from years ago and read that there were a lot of wooden headstones at some point in time. Here might be something. I don't know how old that would be, but I imagine with time, you know, wood rots and fades away, and there's really no sign of any old wooden headstones. So that's why a lot of these poor folks out here are lost to memory, most likely. Okay, so you see that white structure out there? That's the historic Agua Caliente Resort, I believe. I'm pretty sure about that. And over here, there's a couple things that I read about on the internet in my quick research that really are just generically referred to as things as the stone house or the shack. So I really am not going to be able to give you information as to whose shacks and whose residences these were, but I think these are from the era that we are going to study today.
I'm already quite impressed. I wasn't expecting much today along the ways of this kind of stuff, but already it exceeds my expectations now that I'm seeing it with my own eyes. And there's actually more right over there. We'll explore it all, but let's go see if we can connect with the past. And then I'll tell you more stories about Agua Caliente.
Now you do see concrete and things that indicate to me a little bit later of a time than the 1800s. And yeah, this place did have a prime existence in the very late 1800s into the 1900s, but the settlement and the discovery of this area goes all the way back to the 1860s or 50s, I want to say. So lots of history in this area, much forgotten. Looks like a lot of old wood beams, old window frames, maybe door frames, beds. You could see iron beds, spring beds. Maybe the place is that the old visitors of the old days that came to seek out the healing waters.
Tell you a little bit about Agua Caliente. So the word, I doubt that I need to say this, it's obviously Spanish and it means hot water. And the name came from the natural springs, the hot springs here that I think are located over by the resort. But a whole industry popped up around this stuff, and you could even find accounts going back to the pioneer days of people coming to these springs for their healing properties. I read a couple accounts from people back in the 1860s that came and soaked their bones in here and remarked on the healing properties that the springs contained. This is pretty neat also. If you take a look, it's a closer look at the rock that they built this place with. Quite impressive, actually. And sturdy, too. I always love seeing remnants of stucco or things like this on the walls, really. It just gives it more character and more of a sense of place for me, until you see the graffiti carved in on some of these things. But for the most part, pretty much untouched and in good shape. Here's another small building, which I don't think I'm going to be able to get into. We'll see. Looks like it's filled with debris. But same style, same kind of rocks for the foundation. And on the other side, I actually think I see even more. So there's a lot more here than I thought. And here's where I'm really calling on the history buffs here that might know this stuff. Like, what are these buildings? Let's hear about some people that lived here. Maybe one of your relatives from the past came here to seek out the healing waters in the past. Someone out there has stories to tell. Now, to give you an idea of how old this resort was and how you used to get here, there's a town called Sentinel off of Interstate 8 where we kind of started today. And that used to actually be a stop on the Southern Pacific Railroad. And if you wanted to come visit this place, you would have gotten here by horse, by buggy. And I was reading an article from 1904, from the 1904 World's Fair. We'll put it in a link in the description down below, but a real account of this place. And they mentioned that that ride from Sentinel to here cost $5 round trip. Now that sounds like a bargain, doesn't it? But we got to talk about 1904 money. That's about $168 is what I read in 1904 money. Now when we get up closer to that resort over there, I'll tell you some other cool things that I read in that 1904 document, that pamphlet from the World's Fair. I think it was the St. Louis World's Fair, 1904, if I remember correctly. And that was probably the most definitive thing that I've read about this place, although a lot of 1904 type of science going on, which isn't like today's science. Over here looks like some older building techniques, like adobe or some kind of mud technique they used to build this, but it also has like this concrete-like outer structure that line the walls, and I don't really rightly know what that is. Maybe it is cement of some sort, but yeah, I didn't see mud bricks on the other thing here, but this thing's gonna melt away with time, but it's still standing. Maybe this is evidence of something more 1800s. And if you keep walking, you just see one after another. There's another foundation, not much left of that one, but I think we get the idea over here. But I'm really enjoying this. This section is aesthetically pleasing to me. You know, I know those of you that have come to this channel have been watching for a while, or maybe you're new and you found this video because you were searching for information. We all appreciate rubble, I think, if you've come here, hopefully. And I just always wonder, like, what is it? I mean, for me, it's trying to connect to the past and think about the people that lived here, their struggles, things like that, and just to see the connections, the evidence, the graves, things like that. It excites me. But there's just something aesthetically pleasing about it also. Something very picture-worthy, I find. That's why I come here, to places like this. So something interesting that I noted is I did some recon with the drone and flew around the landscape to see if I could spot stuff. Took a fly over the resort over there, the one that I read about years ago, had no trespassing signs posted. And I see a big group of people parked in there exploring the resort area. So that might be a good sign. We might be able to go take a closer look than I was thinking. It changes everything. But first, there's another building up here that I've seen referred to only as the shack. That small thing up there. And I'm gonna go take a quick look at that guy. Very sturdy foundation.
and that corrugated metal, you could see the roof is rotting and it's still there, but for the most part, this is one of the most intact structures here in Agua Caliente today, other than the modern stuff going on. But once again, probably a relic of the 20th century here, not the 1800s, when this was more ranch land and Apache territory. Now, it wouldn't be complete if we didn't go into each and every structure that we can without getting in trouble, of course, and surmise as to what this may have been at one point. You could see like a screen up there. My best guess is like maybe a very small guest cabin, or perhaps like a tool shed, or maybe even the residence of someone that lived and worked in this area over 100 years ago. But I wouldn't be surprised if we're looking at something in the 100 years old plus range. Yeah, like look what I am talking about here. You just see all of these walls everywhere, and these are quite sizable. So was that a really large building? Seems odd, because the hill that it's on is not level, so that doesn't make much sense. So maybe it was just like a fenced in area or some kind of corral of some sort, I don't know, but that would be odd to build this thing on uneven ground like that, unless it got filled in. And all of these cans, I have seen more cans here today than anywhere on any of my journeys that are in this like kind of pristine state. I've even found some that weren't even opened yet. The contents were empty, but the top and bottoms were intact. So that's really cool, but this is a garbage heap. There are just rusted out cans everywhere.
All right, well, let's go take a peek here and see what we can find over there at the resort. My plan was really thinking that it was gonna be completely off limits and no trespassing signs everywhere, but the evidence of people over there makes me think otherwise maybe. And I was just gonna use a drone to fly over the property. So really quite pleased that we might be able to get in there. How do I get down from this hill now?
I mean, this is a fantastic structure. And I really couldn't tell you if this is original 1897 handiwork or probably renovated and built over throughout the years. But yeah, people used to come seek out these springs as a destination, and this is where they would stay.
But this is it, the Agua Caliente Resort, the facade that I think I've seen in many old-time photos where you have old cars parked out here in front, all black and white. And at one point, I think the original building was called Modesti's Hotel, if I'm remembering correctly. That was in that 1904 article I read about, but I think painted here on the top, it would have at one point said Agua Caliente Resort, right up there above the corrugated roof. Now, when I flew over, I'm trying to remember what I saw when I was looking through the finder. I thought I saw like an open area, but I think there was supposed to have been a pool around here at one time where they would have filled it with the spring water. But it said that farming like in the 1940s and ranching in the area pretty much sucked up the aquifer and it's dry and the springs died. So the only reminder that we have of that is this building here.
I guess all of the frequent doorways are indicators of like old hotel rooms. You know, these would have been the rooms probably that patrons would have been checking out to stay here at the time.
In the 1904 World's Fair article that we're gonna link to down below, they actually have a really interesting information about this very place. Somebody wrote a quick little, you know, short pamphlet about the chemical makeup of the water. Like I think I was reading like the sodium bicarbonates, the other types of salts that were good for the skin. They talked about how it cured dyspepsia, it cured alcoholism, it cured nicotine poisoning was another interesting one that I recall they talked about, but the list was very long. It cured a lot of stuff apparently, but it certainly did soothe some sore muscles, I'm sure. You know, one of the sensory things that I really like about this place is it's probably not sealed up like that tight. And with the wind blowing and stuff, I think there's air currents coming out and occasionally you get the whiff of that old wood smell, that really musty old smell. And it makes me really want to see what's beyond these doors, but maybe another time. If you own this property and you see this video, let's talk. I'm gonna be a little bold and just kind of hang out here on the front, not be disruptive or bother, but I want to tell you another tale that I heard about this place before this would have been here. Some of you probably are familiar with something called the Oatman Massacre, and that happened very near here in this geographic region. And don't worry, the Cactus Atlas is doing an episode on that very soon. But the myth goes, or the legend goes, that after the Oatman girls were kidnapped by the Apache, the Yavapai, the first stop they made was at these springs. And I feel like a creep because there's a direct line of sight to the party in there. Hopefully I'm not, I think it's pretty clear that I'm a photographer and doing some historic work here, but you know, I like to keep the etiquette on the right side. Another interesting tale that I heard was from Woolsey's time here. And I read something like when people would go to soak in the springs before, once again, the structure was here, they had to have lookouts looking out for raiding Apache because the Apache did not take kindly to this. They called this their medicine water. So imagine for generations, this was really something that you and your culture had access to. And then another culture comes in and steals it away and has basically builds on top of it. So once the railroad came through though, that was about the time where, yeah, the Apache started to go to far more distant places. But yeah, it's just really interesting to think of the history when you take all of that into account. On these lands where my feet are now, chances are Apache walked on the same footsteps. All right, Agua Caliente, worthy stop on this tour. I think the next one's gonna be delightful and fun too. A little bit different vibe, but it fits with the theme, as you will see. Off to Sundad, Arizona, we go. All right, so Agua Caliente, how cool is that? Yeah, this next destination, Sundad, is actually not that far. Mileage-wise, it's 17 miles, but Google's saying it's about a half an hour because I think we're gonna be going off pavement here soon. All right, as we make our way to Sundad, and I can talk to you without the wind blowing all the time, the little I know about this place is back in the 1920s, it's thought that Sundad was a place where people afflicted with tuberculosis could come to ease their symptoms or maybe try to cure themselves, as was very common here in the Southwest. We saw one such place out in New Mexico, if you guys remember that adventure. But the only thing with Sundad is there's really nothing there now. Nothing tangible to that time, maybe a concrete foundation or two, I've heard. There's something else about Sundad that I think will pique our interest. And we have officially driven to where the pavement ends, and now Slim and I are in familiar turf. I guess the most excitement we've had all today is this railroad crossing. Hopefully this thing works.
Continue on Agua Caliente Road for 4 miles.
I get paranoid out here, man. I don't trust this. Oh, actually, that must be like an old railroad track because there are no tracks where I just drove. That's pretty cool. I don't think that railroad is in service. Is that a railroad from the olden times? Probably not. Surely not. Is that the old Southern Pacific? I don't think that would be up here, though. See a lot of roads named the Butterfield Stage Road in this region, and the Butterfield Stage Coach did, as we've talked about before in different episodes, one of the major route went through this area. So one day we will seek out evidence of that, but just remarking because this road is called Butterfield Stage Road. Some random trivia for you, I guess, as we drive. So enjoyable, just the ride. Hopefully you enjoy riding with me and exploring. How many of you all out there just do this for fun? Am I the only one? Or do I provide your fun by bringing you with me on these things? But surely some of you just like to go drive in the middle of nowhere for fun, right? It's that adventurer spirit, I think. It's just you want to know what's around every corner. Maybe some of us do. I know I do. Alrighty, folks, welcome to Sundad, Arizona. What you think about this? pretty sweet, isn't it?
Even from the ground, from the correct angle, you can deduce what some of these symbols are. That would be a star, I presume, and some squiggly things and peace signs almost, it looks like. I don't know if that's a peace sign. But luckily we have a drone and we can see the stuff from the air. But yeah, this is what we've come here for. And this is, there's more of this where this came from. This isn't it, but this is the first sign that we're onto the correct place.
And now we explore and ponder the mystery of Sundad, which is somebody took the time to build geoglyphs everywhere. I would assume somebody from modern times. This isn't like ho-ho-com geoglyphs or something, but I could not find out who or what happened here. So maybe it was the aliens, but it lends a little bit of mystery to this. Someone took the time to make these things in this place. So now this is where if we got really stinking lucky, somebody's like granddaddy's daddy worked here or knew what this was, and there's a story passed down into the family. Or maybe it was your crazy uncle or one of the black sheep of the family that came out to the desert and took a lot of drugs and did something like this. Whatever the story is, I want to know. I really do.
Okay, so that's the beginning of Sundad. Hopefully not the end. I think there's maybe more. Google Maps takes you here. There's a little road that goes in a little bit further and it loops out at the end. And I want to say there's more stuff like this back there. So we're going to go do a quick exploration or maybe see if we can find evidence of the past while we're at it. But I'll take you on back there. I think if you're really super careful, still so far, you could probably get back here with just about any vehicle. And that's a recent rain tears it up or something like that. But at the very least, maybe if you want to play on the cautious side, you could park out where that main entrance was and then walk on foot. It doesn't look like it's terribly that far to go back to where we're going. But Google, if you ask Google to take you there, she's going to drop you off at the front there. Ah, and here we go. Here's where I might change my advice to you Ford Pinto drivers. You might want to not come out here. Yeah, and you got washes like this, and then, oh yeah, I was reading online, somebody I think I recall said it gets a little hairy back here, and here you go. All right, Slim, you got this, buddy, you got this. All right, so that looks like a V and an R. That looks like an arrow. It's kind of fun to try to figure out what it is before we get up in the air, because that's kind of cheating, right? And I think this spells Sundad also. So there's two Sundad signs. And I'm seeing many concrete foundations. So I thought I read there might be like one, but I will guess that we are actually in downtown Sundad right here. Whatever the heck Sundad used to be. See if we can sniff it out. How the hell are we gonna be able to tell from this though?
I do think there's a lot of credence to the tuberculosis retreat theory. And maybe that's what this is. These are maybe small cabins that people would have stayed in. It's kind of sad to think about though, and eerie in a way. You know, being out here in the middle of nowhere, truly, truly nobody now, I am on my own. And thinking, you know, there were maybe ailing, suffering people. Maybe people died here, quite likely, I would say. So that's kind of I don't like that feeling, but just a really strange place. Strange vibe. I would also think if it was the 1920s, there would also be some kind of photographic evidence of this place out there somewhere. So there's got to be one photo in existence that shows what this place looked like in its heyday.
I don't know what this was. Was this like maybe a water pump or something like that? And this actually here, there's a lot more to this than I was thinking we'd see. There's actually geometry happening, folks, right in front of your eyes in 3D. I don't know if this is anything to anybody. was it just a barrel to, you know, put fluids in or something? Looks like there was a way to screw something in there at the bottom. Just trying to find clues to things like ovens or, you know, a range or something, or a bed spring, to give evidence to the theory that this was some kind of a health resort. See a lot of old rusty cans again that probably all washed down there in the rain down towards the wash is my best guess, and they're destined to be washed away many miles. I like looking for clues like Sherlock Holmes up in here. Is that evidence of rust? Could it have been that there may have been like a metal roof at one point and it leaked and rust got onto the floor here? Probably not. I imagine too, this is probably covered at one point by something like wood flooring or carpet, something like that. But I'm stretching, I'm looking for something here, trying to interpret and make sense of this. So I guess let's start something in the comments here, and everybody put your best guess down there. Feel free to do research, and whoever finds out first, I don't know what you win. Respect. Okay, so if this is locally sourced junk, then if this ceramic is also locally sourced and from the era from whenever this stuff came from, I see a lot of ceramic like this, probably from toilets and sinks and things like that, making me wonder, is that evidence that they had running water out here? So I'm trying to think of like a theme for this video, and it just seems like we've been seeking out ghost towns that are here for reasons having nothing to do with mining or anything else. They're both very unique in their own way, I think. All right, folks, I'm gonna part ways with you here at the Sundad Junk Vortex, as we're gonna call it from now on. All I'm gonna leave you with is, if Agua Caliente wasn't cool enough and you want to come out here, I could really use your help to help solve the mystery of what Sundad, Arizona was. I'll see you next time.